The news of the nomination of US President Donald Trump for the Nobel Peace Prize came as a heartburn for the left liberals all around the world, and they instantly started demonizing the president by giving false equivalences to satiate their bruised egos. Whether Trump receives the Peace Prize or not is a different debate. But the American president, barely days after the nomination, has brokered another landmark deal in the Middle East that aims to bring peace amidst the chaos of West Asia and simultaneously pushes back on China and its nefarious plans in the region. US President Donald Trump on Friday announced a peace deal between Israel and Bahrain. Bahrain becomes the second Arab country in West Asia after the United Arab Emirates to establish peace with its former foe Israel over the last 1 month, reinforcing an ambitious White House push to redraw the conflicts of the Middle East. Muslim-majority Kosovo has also established diplomatic ties with Israel at the behest of Trump. On this wonderful development, Donald Trump tweeted, "Another historic breakthrough today. Our two great friends, Israel and the Kingdom of Bahrain, agree to a peace deal, the second Arab country to make peace with Israel in 30 days. A joint statement issued by the three leaders said that they agreed on the establishment of full diplomatic relations between Israel and the Kingdom of Bahrain. The joint statement said, "This is a historic breakthrough to further peace in the Middle East, opening direct dialogue and ties between these two dynamic societies and advanced economies will continue the positive transformation of the Middle East and increase stability, security, and prosperity in the region." Israel and Bahrain had a secret relationship for over two decades, meaning most of their contacts were through covert talks behind the scenes, as neither country had diplomatic relations. However, the talks, which led to the joint statement on establishing full diplomatic relations, took just 29 days. With this settlement and the earlier one between the United Arab Emirates and Israel, the USA has filled the void in West Asia that had been caused by Trump's decision to move out his armed forces from the region and the decreasing oil business with the Gulf. As reported by TFI, the wild Xi Jinping regime had anticipated these tectonic shifts in the region and had started to make its movements to replace USA in the region. But the sledgehammer Trump has brought on China's ambitions in the last few weeks has brought a tough setback for Beijing. The United States under Trump had distanced itself from the wars of the Middle East. Trump understood that America had lost far too many lives in West Asia, and therefore it didn't want to involve itself further in the mess created by his predecessors like Obama or George W. Bush. However, a prancing Beijing thought this was an opportunity to take over West Asia by pumping in the funds and forging trade alliances in the region using the animosity of Gulf countries against one another. China was trying to build its presence across the crucial economic choke points in the region, the Strait of Hormuz, Bab al-Mandab, and the Suez Canal, which handle considerable oil traffic apart from forming vital links in the trade routes through this region. China had started investing heavily in the Suez Canal to develop the corridor so as to exert influence on one of the most profitable routes of the world and later use it for its own leverage. Beijing wanted to occupy the space left behind by the United States and in turn hurt India's interests in the region by blocking the choke points, which will hinder oil supplies and imperil trade routes. China had a military base in Djibouti exclusively for this purpose. China's eagerness to take over from America could be gauged from the fact that Beijing kept stepping up its investments in the Gulf region despite scaling down its investments elsewhere due to a slowdown in the Chinese economy and the backlash received in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. But the last 2 weeks have turned the tide, and the US president has gained the favor of almost the entire region. These huge diplomatic victories for Donald Trump make sure that the Trump administration can now dictate the events of the region, not militarily, but on the contrary, diplomatically. Trump is the first American president in decades who has departed from the White House policy of military intervention and regime change wars in the Middle East. While his past two predecessors ended their presidential terms with war-torn countries like Libya, Iraq, and Syria, Trump is going to end his first term with fewer troops in West Asia and the Arab-Israel peace accords that make the region much more peaceful than it ever was in recent memory. With all of Trump's diplomatic achievements in the Middle East, the Chinese dream of emulating America and using it for world domination has gone up in smokes. Xi Jinping and his Communist Party have been left seething through their teeth.